guys, we got these beans from Aldi, and I'm not sure how much they were. They were really, really cheap. I wanted to show you guys what it looks like, and then also look at this. My little girl, you looking cute. She been wanting some beignets for the longest time.
Gosh, it's my birthday.
So, when we come back, we will show you guys. This is actually from Cafe Du Monde. I've heard a lot about them in New Orleans, Louisiana. So, that's going to be fun. And they actually had the coffee, too. So, maybe I'll try to get that. Oh, wow. It's got a lot of liquid in there. Right, you want me to? No, to see. Right. Yeah. Oh, my. Let me get a spoon for that. Dr. Pepper baked beans. What was it that I made of Dr. Pepper? The meat in the crock pot.
Oh,
that was a chicken. Good.
Chicken.
Ooh.
It's sweet.
Oh, it tastes just like the soda. Oh. I don't know how I feel about that. Maybe after they're heated.
Yeah.
All right, y'all. So when we come back, we're going to show you how we're going to make these beignets. I'm so excited. Hey, y'all. I'm back with the beignets. We're going to try to attempt to make these today. What we're going to make today is going to amount to 2 dozen of these. These are French donuts. I don't know if we're going to do the chocolate sauce in the middle of some of these or not, because that's the way Popeyes had theirs. You hear my air fryer. That's what's going on in the back. And we'll be right back. Oil is getting hot. I'm going to open this. I'm trying to smell it, y'all.
Smell it, man?
Not really. You want to smell it?
Oh.
Be careful with that hot. Grease is getting hot. So this say 2 cups. After that, we need 7 ounces of water. Okay. This is so nice that this has the ounces. This only has, does this have to be, it don't say warm or cool. This only has 6 ounces, so I'm gonna have to try and guess. Try and be in the middle. 7 ounces here. Try to make a little well in there.
That's smart.
And pour. Okay. She is so excited about this thing, y'all.
Yes.
Be careful, Adrian.
That's all.
Yeah, okay. Been caught up in the fire up on this video, and they're going to be looking at me. So I'm like, you ain't warning your daughter. You ain't warning your daughter. Evelyn Lozada, my daughter. Daughter. Yep, that didn't take long. Mm-mm. Oh, it didn't take long at all. All right, so we got to try to figure out how to, we're going to roll this out. We'll figure it out, y'all. I'll be back. Okay, so I got it. Flour surface here. Oil is thing I'm good at baking is sweet potato pies, y'all. So this right here. And they said you gotta keep putting flour on it. So I don't know. So has anybody had beignets before? My little rolling pin. My little girl right here got me. Aja says, come on, y'all. Wait for more videos from her.
I'm coming.
Okay, y'all. So it's rolling. I'm not sure how accurate we're going to be on. Right. So I'm going to do this for y'all. And, you know, we got a whole nother batch. To do. Okay. And this mix actually came from a store called Giant. I don't know what I went down that aisle to get, but I just have to see. To 2 1/4 square of chow. I'm gonna assume. You guys can't really see what I'm doing. But this is what I'm cutting them into squares. They're probably gonna puff up. Some big ones right there. I feel like the oil is not as hot as I like it to be. It feels like it's hot though. Let's start. See something happening? Hey, y'all don't feel like it's fast enough. You know, I feel like it may fall apart, but if I pick it up.
Oh.
Oh, no. Improvise or something. Because it's like real sticky, y'all. We made donuts from the Pillsbury biscuits cans, and they always come out good. You just sprinkle them with some powdered sugar. Take what out?
The powdered sugar.
Oh. Y'all. This is like. I was trying to get, you know, keep it in that square shape. I feel like it should be thicker, y'all. Let's see. Like I said, it is trial and error.
That's good.
out to the donut people that make donuts. Is it?
Right.
I guess once you have it down. I guess it's like with anything, once you have it down pat, you good to go. It shouldn't be sticking like this. She can't help me because she's holding her camera. I just needed more flour, y'all. Cause it was just sticking. Like I said, it's supposed to be in a square shape, but that don't look like it's happening today. Not with this batch.
It's doing awesome.
Yeah, it's trying to blow up. You keep flour liberally on dough. So. Oh, Andy, you gotta watch out, girl. Dangerously, don't you?
Yeah.
Not to be screaming in pain and I had to call an ambulance and ain't no for no video. Girl, you crazy? What you mean, what? Didn't I just go through this with that movie we just watched yesterday?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, well, I watched it the second time.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
All right, so I got a little bit of powdered sugar.
Ooh.
Not the shape that I want, but okay. Okay. Let's say tell light and puffy and golden. Drain well. This one light skin right now. This one right here. She light skin. She light skin. Try to get her some color. She got a little color. Okay, Ada. You know, I mean, they look like croissants.
Yeah.
Right now. I guess that's what we're looking for. And you know, you think I should pull these out? What do you think?
Yeah.
Cause she know I got a tendency to overcook stuff. Okay, y'all. just while it's hot, y'all. Careful with that grease aid, I'm trying to tell you. Forever for the grease to cool off. I mean, heat up. And when it heat up, Mater, it's your thing. So, y'all, the video cut off on me due to low storage, but we all agree the beignets taste kind of like in between a funnel cake and a donut. We hope you enjoy watching us making beignets for the first time. I'm sure my daughter will have me making them for her a lot.